of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Welcome, brothers and sisters, as we gather here to pray this very joyful occasion so that we can pray well. Let us take a moment and call to mind our sinfulness. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, who out of the abundance of your untold grace alone choose to set your servant and priest Stephen over your church of Fairbanks this day, grant that he may carry out worthily the office of bishop, and under your governance in all things, he may direct by word and example the people entrusted to his care. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, because the Lord has anointed me. He has sent me to bring glad tidings to the lowly, to heal the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives and release to the prisoners, to announce a year of favor from the Lord and a day of vindication by our God, to comfort all who mourn, to place on those who mourn in Zion a diadem instead of ashes, to give them oil of gladness in place of mourning, a glorious mantle instead of a listless spirit. The word of the Lord.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to Timothy. Beloved, I remind you to stir into flame the gift of God you have through the imposition of my hands. For God did not give us a spirit of cowardice, but rather of power and self-control. So do not be ashamed of your testimony to our Lord, nor of me, a prisoner, for his sake, but bear your share of hardship for the gospel with the strength that comes from God. He saved us and called us to a holy life, not according to our works, but according to his own design and the grace bestowed on us in Christ Jesus before time began, but now made manifest through the appearance of our Savior, Christ Jesus, who destroyed death and brought life and immortality to light through the gospel, for which I was appointed preacher and apostle and teacher. On this account, I am suffering these things, but I am not ashamed, for I know him in whom I have believed, and am confident that he is able to guard what has been entrusted to me until that day. Take as your norm the sound words that you heard from me, in the faith and love that are in Christ Jesus. Guard this rich trust with the help of the Holy Spirit that dwells within us. The word of the Lord.
Gospel of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O
Jesus said to his disciples, "As the Father loves me, so also I love you. Remain in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will remain in my love. Just as I have kept my Father's commandments and remain in my love, in his love. I have told you this so that my joy may be in you and your joy might be complete. This is my commandment. Love one another as I love you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for his friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I no longer call you slaves, because a slave does not know what his master is doing. I have called you friends, because I have told you everything I have heard from my Father. It was not you who chose me, but I who chose you and appointed to you to go and bear fruit that will remain, so that whatever you ask the Father in my name, he may give you. This I command you, love one another. The Gospel of the Lord.
Thank you. Most Reverend Father, the Church of Fairbanks asks you to ordain this priest, Stephen, to the responsibility of the episcopate.
Have you a mandate from the Apostolic See?
We have.
Let it be read.
Your Excellency, Archbishop Belisario, and all my brother bishops, dear priests, deacons, consecrated religious and members of the faithful, and I want to mention in a special way the big group of your brother, sons of St. Dominic. You have come, I think we have counted more or less 30. Some people ask me, I don't know if it is true, will they stay here in Fairbanks? You know, I am tempted to call the Pope and to give you order to stay. You don't applaud for that? So it is truly my pleasure to be with you today as the personal representative of Pope Francis. When Pope John Paul II visited Fairbanks in 1984, he said, I quote, "Today, I am here in person to give you the assurance that I have not forgotten you. Even when I am miles away, I hold the people of Alaska and those of the whole of the United States close to me in my heart. I do not forget you, for we are linked by bonds of friendship, of faith, and of love." Likewise, Pope Francis wants you to know of his spiritual closeness and paternal affection, even though he cannot be here in person. Archbishop Belisario, thank you for the care that you have given to the people of God in this local church for the last year. I know that you, together with the people, are joyful because of what we celebrate today. Ever since the transfer of Bishop Zielinski to Minnesota last fall, the people of this diocese prayed faithfully for their next shepherd. 3 months ago, they were introduced to the man they had been praying for, Father Stephen Maekawa. And today, we all rejoice in his ordination as the sixth bishop of the Diocese of Fairbanks. Bishop-elect Maekawa, thank you for your yes. Not only for your yes to Pope Francis when he elected you to be a bishop this year, but for your yes more than 30 years ago when you responded to God's call to enter formation with the Order of Friars Preachers and eventually to become a priest. Your yes to God has taken you many places and has involved you in ministry of great variety. You have directed the Campus Newman Center, served as a military chaplain, including a deployment to Afghanistan, cared for those discerning their vocations, and you have been a parish priest, most recently here in Alaska. By saying yes to God's plan for your life, you have allowed the Holy Spirit to work for the care and salvation of many people. Not only that, but you have brought others along in this missionary work, including some of your fellow Dominican friars. With your yes to this new calling to be a bishop, you have every reason to believe that God will continue to spread the gospel of Jesus to many people and places, especially throughout the great expanse of Central and Northern Alaska. May the example of your yes to God inspired many others, including the young, to say a similar yes to God's invitation to follow him. Now, I will read the papal decree appointing you as Bishop of Fairbanks. You know, this decree is written in Latin. I will give you a translation, and then the document signed by the Holy Father, you will look at it, will be shown by the bishop himself. Francis, Bishop, servant of the servants of God, to our beloved son, Stephen Maekawa, a member of the Friars of the Order of Preachers, until now pastor of Holy Family Parish in Anchorage, in the Archdiocese of Anchorage, Juneau, appointed Bishop of Fairbanks, greetings and apostolic blessing. The sound of the proclamation of the gospel, carried through many nations and many regions, is extended to the whole world through the ministry of bishops, so that all of the faithful may be able to reach safely the harbor of eternal salvation. Accordingly, since the church in Fairbanks has become in this time vacant owing to the transfer of its former bishop, our venerable brother Chad William Zielinski, to the see of New Ulm, we, on our part, carefully fulfilling the ministry of governing in the Lord, desire to appoint there a new ordinary, lest that holy mission of guiding souls be by chance neglected. For these reasons, we look to you, beloved son, who are clearly endowed with practical experience, prudence, and pastoral zeal, as well as an ardent devotion to preaching the gospel. These qualities allow us to maintain the hope that you are capable of fulfilling correctly this office. Therefore, upon consultation with the Dicastery for Bishops, by virtue of our apostolic authority, we appoint you Bishop of the Diocese of Fairbanks, conferring upon you all the due rights and imposing the relative obligations in accordance with the laws of the Code of Canon Law. Consequently, we ask that you inform as soon as possible, we are doing it now, by the way, both the people and the clergy of your community about this, our letter. As to your episcopal ordination, you may receive it from any Catholic bishop anywhere outside the city of Rome. However, prior to this, as established by ecclesiastical law, you must make the profession of faith and take the oath of fidelity toward us and our successors in this see. Finally, we exhort you to carry out your ministry diligently, prudently, and indeed paternally, entrusting yourself and your determination each day to the protection of the Blessed Virgin Mary and her spouse, Saint Joseph, as well as that of Saint Dominic and Saint Stephen, so that they may implore for you the light of the Holy Spirit to preach more faithfully the joy of the gospel. Given at Rome, at St. John Lateran, on the 11th day of July, in the year of the Lord 2023, the 11th of our pontificate, and it is signed Pope Francis.
Rejoice in the Lord always. I shall say it again, rejoice. These are the words of St. Paul, the apostle, in his letter to the Philippians, exhorting his people to rejoice, allowing themselves to experience the great joy of being followers of Christ, knowing that Jesus deeply loves them. St. Paul focuses their attention on the second coming of our Lord as they zealously participate in the church's evangelization mission, together as brothers and sisters, united in that mission. Rejoice in the Lord always. I shall say it again, rejoice. We are here, the local church in northern Alaska, the Diocese of Fairbanks, many years removed from when St. Paul wrote that exhortation, half a world away and much farther north than he could have imagined. We're gathered here in this place in prayer and celebration, filled with great joy, knowing that Jesus deeply loves us. We gaze with great faith and hope across the tundra, over the mountains, toward the end of time, when Christ will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We actively and joyfully participate in the evangelization mission of the church as Jesus commanded, go, therefore, and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. No matter the challenges or the hardships that fulfilling the mission may bring, we are and shall ever be joyful followers of Christ. We are grateful to God and filled with great joy because God has given us a shepherd to lead, guide, govern, teach, sanctify, unify, and love us. Brothers and sisters, I welcome you to this joyful occasion. I want to welcome you, Cardinal Pierre. Fewer than 2 weeks ago, you were in Rome receiving the red hat from Pope Francis as he elevated you to the rank of cardinal. We all want to congratulate you. We are honored that you are with us and that you are gracing us here in Alaska. Welcome. I welcome my brother bishops, Cardinal Mahoney, priests, deacons, religious, sisters and brothers, dignitaries, the people of God from the Diocese of Fairbanks, all our Alaska Native brothers and sisters, people of faith, fellow Christians, and people of goodwill throughout Alaska and beyond. We welcome you, Father Stephen Maekawa of the Order of Preachers, the bishop-elect and soon to be Bishop of Fairbanks. And a very special warm welcome to your family who are here, your Dominican family, and your parishioners from Holy Family Old Cathedral, all of whom support you here and from afar. Welcome, one and all. Bishop-elect Stephen, we're here today with joy in our hearts, as been mentioned many times over the past couple days, because when Pope Francis appointed you bishop of this vast missionary diocese of Fairbanks, you responded to God's call with a humble but a dynamic commitment. Yes, I accept. Your commitment and the anointing that you will receive today recall our first reading from Isaiah, words that Jesus himself proclaimed. The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, because the Lord has anointed me. He has sent me to bring good news to the afflicted, to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to captives, release to the prisoners, to announce a year of favor of the Lord. The anointing of the Lord compels you to action. God sends you to serve his people. The title of bishop is one of service, not of honor. And therefore, a bishop should strive to benefit others. You are chosen by the Lord from among men and appointed on behalf of the people for those things that pertain to God. Our Lord Jesus Christ, sent by the Father to redeem the human race, sent 12 apostles into the world. They were filled with the power of the Holy Spirit to preach the gospel and to sanctify and to govern the people gathered into one flock. That this office might remain to the end of time, the apostles chose helpers for themselves. Through the laying on of hands by which the fullness of the sacrament of holy orders is conferred, they handed on to them the gift of the Holy Spirit, which they received from Christ. In that way, the tradition handed down from the beginning through the unbroken succession of bishops is preserved, and the work of the Savior continues on and grows even to our own times. As a successor of the apostles, you pray, serve, and offer sacrifice for the people committed to your care, seeking every kind of grace for them from the fullness of Christ's holiness. Always be always mindful of the Good Shepherd, who knows his sheep and is known by them, and who did not hesitate to lay down his life for them. As a member of the College of Bishops in the Catholic Church, made one by the bond of charity, you are to have constant concern for all the churches and come to the support of churches in need. The church entrusted to you, the Diocese of Fairbanks, is big, very big in area. It is in the far north, in both the subarctic and Arctic regions of the world, with the accompanying climate and geographical challenges. It is within that territory are the people that you have committed to serve as their shepherd, who are spread out over an immense area. Beginning with Saints Peter and Paul and the apostles, all bishops are missionaries. Here in Alaska, the missionary challenges are pronounced. Your two most recent predecessors are here to support you today, Bishop Donald Kettler and Bishop Chad Zielinski. They and many other Catholic bishops have blazed the trails that you will travel. John Charles Sagers was a Belgian priest and a contemporary of Father Damien of Molokai. He was filled with missionary zeal for the salvation of souls. He's considered the father of the Catholic Alaska mission. In 1873, he was appointed the Bishop of Vancouver Island. He made 5 visits to Alaska, which was included at that time in his diocese. In June of 1878, he left Nulato, Alaska, a place you visited just last month, where he had set up a temporary headquarters and set sail to San Francisco. There he learned that he had been appointed coadjutor Archbishop of Oregon City. After 2 years, he petitioned Pope Leo XIII to be reassigned to Vancouver again, which the Pope granted his request. This assignment allowed him to return to missionary work in Alaska. In 1886, making good on a promise to the people of Nulato that he had made 8 years earlier that he would return, the Archbishop made the months-long trip back to Nulato. But on the day or two before he was scheduled to arrive, a traveling companion, killed the archbishop. His blood intermingled with the sacred soil of Alaska. Father Joseph Raphael John Cremon, a Jesuit priest who likewise experienced a strong call to missionary activity, was named Bishop of the new Vicariate of Alaska in 1917. And for the next 28 years, Bishop Cremon traveled the length and the breadth of Alaska, evangelizing, visiting, teaching, and celebrating the sacraments for the people. He traveled much during the summers, especially here in northern Alaska, visiting the various villages, missions, and parishes. And during his winters in Juneau, he shared his time between his duties as a bishop and a parish priest. He died in Juneau at age 87 in 1945. This French Jesuit, Bishop Cremon, named St. Therese of Lisieux as patroness of the Vicariate of Alaska at that same time in 1917, which was somewhat unusual because St. Therese was not canonized until 1925. But Bishop Cremon knew some of her family members, and he was convinced of her sanctity and missionary heart. He was present in Rome when she was canonized and officially declared queen and patroness of Alaska. Saint Therese took the command of Jesus seriously, which we heard today in today's gospel reading, to love one another. She writes in her autobiography, "Charity gave me the key to my vocation. I understood that the church had a heart and that this heart was burning with love. I knew that one love drove the members of the church to action, that if this love were extinguished, the apostles would have proclaimed the gospel no longer, and the martyrs would have shed their blood no more. I understood that love comprised all vocations, that love was everything, that it embraced all times and all places, in a word, that it was eternal. Then, in the excess of my delirious joy, I cried out, 'O Jesus, my love, my vocation at last, I have found it. My vocation is love.'" Following the command of Jesus, our Alaska patroness discovered love is a Christian's motivation. Indeed, our vocation is love. It is especially true of bishops, who must love their flock to be good shepherds. Pope Francis often says, the pastors must go out to meet their people, especially to the highways and the byways, to seek out those people who are poor, marginalized, sick, ostracized, and sinful, so that they may experience Jesus's deep love for them and come to know him and to follow him through your ministry. Exhort them to rejoice in the Lord always and say it over and over and over again. This exhortation of St. Paul to rejoice and the appeal by Pope Francis to go to the peripheries, which is what St. Paul did, is essential to our episcopal ministry. It is no surprise for us because it has been the reality of bishops in the last frontier since the beginning. Bishop-elect Stephen, your chosen episcopal motto, Duke in Altum, into deep water, is the exhortation of Jesus to St. Peter, which Pope St. John Paul II endorsed and transmitted with renewed apostolic zeal. It is most appropriate to our Alaska reality. You are a fisher of people, bringing them to the Lord and his church, to become followers of Christ. It expresses well your Dominican priesthood and heart, the heart of a preacher, evangelizer, and educator in constant motion and prayer. As St. Paul reminded Timothy, I remind you to stir into flame the gift of God that you have through the imposition of our hands. Be a bishop in motion, going to your people throughout this boundless land, on the trails, in the boats on the rivers and the sea, in the air, on the snow machines, and on the roads where they exist, to the larger towns and the smaller, more remote villages where Alaska Natives have lived for millennia, always with great joy, with great love and respect, offering the Lord's presence in the sacraments, and through your love for your flock, preaching God's love and mercy. Rejoice in the Lord always. I shall say it again, rejoice. Ancient rule of the Holy Fathers decrees that the one to be ordained bishop should be questioned in the presence of the people concerning his resolve to guard the faith and to discharge this office. Therefore, dear brother, do you resolve to carry out until death, with the grace of the Holy Spirit, the office entrusted to us by the apostles and to be passed on to you through the laying on of our hands?
I do.
Do you resolve to proclaim the gospel of Christ faithfully and unfailingly?
I do.
Do you resolve to guard the deposit of faith, pure and entire, according to the tradition preserved always and everywhere in the church from the time of the apostles?
I do.
Do you resolve to build up the body of Christ, his church, and to remain in her unity with the order of bishops under the authority of the successors of the blessed Apostle Peter?
I do.
Do you resolve to render obedient faithfully to the successor of the blessed Apostle Peter?
I do.
Do you resolve, as a devoted father, to encourage the holy people of God and to guide them in the way of salvation together with the priests and deacons, your fellow ministers?
I do.
Do you resolve, for the sake of the Lord's name, to reach out in kindness and mercy to the poor, to strangers, and to all those in need?
I do.
Do you resolve, as a good shepherd, to seek out the sheep who stray and to gather them into the Lord's fold?
I do.
Do you resolve to pray without ceasing to Almighty God for his holy people and to carry out the office of high priest without reproach?
I do, with the help of God.
May God, who has begun the good work in you, bring it to fulfillment. Let us pray, dearly beloved, that the loving kindness of Almighty God, providing for the welfare of the church, will grant to this chosen one an abundance of his grace.
Let us pray.
Graciously hear our petitions, O Lord, as you raise the horn of priestly grace over this your servant, pour out upon him the power of your blessing through Christ our Lord. God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, Father of mercies, God of all consolation, who dwell on high and look upon the lowly, who know all things before they come to be, it is you who established order in your church through your gracious word, who from the beginning predestined a righteous people born of Abraham, who instituted rulers and priests, and did not leave your sanctuary without ministry, who from the beginning of the world have been pleased to be glorified in those you have chosen. Now pour forth upon this chosen one the power that is from you, the governing spirit whom you gave to your beloved son, Jesus Christ, and whom he gave to the holy apostles, who established the church in each place as your sanctuary, to the glory and unfailing praise of your name. Grant, O Father, knower of all hearts, that this your servant whom you have chosen for the episcopate may nourish your holy flock and may without reproach exercise before you the high priesthood, serving you night and day, that he may unceasingly cause you your face to shine upon us and offer the gifts of your holy church. Grant that by the strength of the Spirit of the High Priesthood, he may have authority to forgive sins according to your command, that he may apportion offices according to your precept, and loosen every bond according to the authority that you gave the apostles. May he be pleasing to you in meekness and purity of heart, offering a sweet fragrance to you. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, through whom glory and power and honor are yours, with the Holy Spirit and the Holy Church, both now and forever and ever. May God, who has made you a sharer in the high priesthood of Christ himself, pour out upon you the oil of mystical anointing and make you fruitful with an abundance of his blessing. Receive the gospel and preach the word of God with all patience and sound teaching. Receive this ring, the seal of fidelity, and adorned with the undefiled faith, preserved unblemished, the bride of Christ, the Holy Church. Receive the mitre and let the splendor of holiness shine in you, so when the chief shepherd appears, you may merit to receive an unfading crown of glory. Receive the crozier, the sign of the pastoral office, and keep watch over the whole flock in which the Holy Spirit has placed you as bishop to govern the Church of God.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, and the praise and glory of his name, for our good and of all his holy church.
We offer you the sacrifice of praise, O Lord, for the deepening of our service to you, so that what you have conferred on us, unworthy as we are, you may graciously bring to fulfillment through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for by the anointing of the Holy Spirit, you made your only begotten Son, High Priest of the new and eternal covenant, and by your wondrous design, you were pleased to decree that his one priesthood should continue in the church. For Christ not only adorns with a royal priesthood the people he has made his own, but with a brother's kindness, he also chooses men to become sharers in his sacred ministry through the laying on of hands. They are to renew in his name the sacrifice of human redemption, to set before your children the paschal banquet, to lead your holy people in charity, to nourish them with the word, and strengthen them with the sacraments. As they give up their lives for you and for the salvation of their brothers and sisters, they strive to be conformed to the image of Christ himself and offer you a constant witness of faith and love. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks, as in exaltation we acclaim. To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant, Francis, our Pope, me, your unworthy servant, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and apostolic faith.
Remember, Lord, your servants. and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them, we offer you the sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying of their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true.
In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints, we ask that through their merits and prayers and all things, we may be defended by your protecting help.
Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family, which we make to you, also for me, your unworthy servant, whom you have been pleased to raise to the order of bishops. And in your mercy, keep safe your gifts in me, so that what I have received by divine commission, I may fulfill by divine assistance. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in once holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be brought poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty, from the gifts you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the Just, the sacrifice of Abraham our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing.
Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace.
To us also, your servants, who though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies. Graciously grant some share in fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord.
Through him, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Peace with you, Bishop.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord.
For the reception of Holy Communion. Remember, you must be Catholic to receive Holy Communion. If you are not, you may come with your hands crossed. There will be 6 stations. Please find the nearest one in front of you. If you're gluten-free, Father Ross will be in the back distributing communion.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Complete within us, O Lord, we pray, the healing work of your mercy, and graciously perfect and sustain us so that in all things we may please you, through Christ our Lord. My brothers and sisters, praise be our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love and life he gives each and every one of us, filling us with his life forever in the Holy Eucharist, calling us to life in the waters of baptism. Today is a very special day, and I thank you as we celebrate this Holy Eucharist and this ordination, my ordination to the episcopacy. It's a day filled with blessing, grace, and gratitude. I thank Holy Father Pope Francis for his faith in the Lord and his trust in me in making this appointment. And a special thank you to our Apostolic Nuncio, Cardinal Christophe Pierre. Thank you so much. And congratulations again on your recent installation as Cardinal. Very much great gratitude and thanksgiving to Archbishop Belisario of Anchorage Juneau, the Archdiocese of Anchorage Juneau, for your continuing support and encouragement. Also, thank you to Bishop Chad Zielinski of New Ulm. Thank you for coming all this distance to be with your faithful as well. I hope to live up by God's grace to follow in the footsteps that you have trod here in this Diocese of Fairbanks. And to Bishop Michael Barber of Oakland, thank you also as well. Many, many stories of the life where we first met each other before going into the chaplaincy on my part, the very first Navy chaplain that I met. But also to thank you to Cardinal Mahoney for being here, for Archbishop Sample, for Archbishop Schweitz. We also thank you, Bishop Smith, Bishop Schuster, and also especially Bishop Kettler, as you also return back to the people who you served so well from 2002 to 2013. Thank you so much for being here. I also want to thank the hard work, organization of the Chancery staff, organizing the liturgies and the hospitality for my guests, Carolyn, Katrina, David, so many others, Father Robert Fath, Father Ross Tazi, and also those all who serve the liturgical ministries today, liturgical ministers and our wonderful choir, our MCs, Father Brandon and Father Jaime, we thank you for your service. To the clergy, religious sisters and brothers and lay ministers of the Diocese of Fairbanks, I thank you as well for being here, whom I am getting to know. I look forward to our working together for the Lord. I also want to acknowledge the clergy and religious sisters and brothers and lay ministers of the Archdiocese of Anchorage Juneau as well, with whom I have joyfully served the faithful these past 7 years. Parishioners from whom I have previously ministered over the past 25 years, it's wonderful to see you. Thank you for joining us today, along with so many of the faithful who have made the journey up from Anchorage. My heartfelt gratitude to the parishioners of Holy Family Old Cathedral in Anchorage, who introduced to me the wonders of Alaska and helped me to fall in love with this great state. Thank you for your witness of faith, charity, and that you have witnessed to me and my brothers in Anchorage. I also want a special thank you, expression of gratitude to my Dominican brothers, to our provincial, the province of the Most Holy Name of Jesus, the very Reverend Christopher Fadock, also joined by the provincial, the province of St. Joseph, the very Reverend Father Alan Moran of our eastern province, to our brothers in the order of my province, my classmates, Father Bart, Father Carl, Father Alejandro, and Father Patrick, and my brothers at the community at Holy Family Old Cathedral. Words cannot adequately express what you mean to me in my vocation as a Dominican friar and as a priest these past 33 years. And brothers, I ask you your forgiveness for having established a house in Fairbanks without asking your permission. I also offer thanksgiving to my family, my sister Karen and her husband Randy, my sister Suzanne and her husband Tony, and their daughter Isabel, my niece, and to my brother Robert, and to my uncles and aunt who are here with us today. Thank you for traveling such a long way to be here to share in this very, very special graced moment for all of the church, for all of us who live in Christ. But a very special thanksgiving to my father, Don, who is here with us today, who instilled in me a great curiosity about the world, taking interest in all that which is around us, going out, doing stuff that's interesting, and to witness great virtues in both in word and in deed, not only to me, but to my sisters and brothers as well. Great gratitude expressed to my mother, Keo, who couldn't be here this day. Down in Seattle, Washington, Mom, you gotta keep praying. It's only just begun. My mother is a convert to the faith, and so much gratitude for teaching her children the faith and teaching us how to pray and introducing us to our Lord Jesus Christ. My mother is a convert and would always tell us, ever since we were very young, always turn to the Lord. If you seek understanding, ask him. If you seek guidance, ask him. If you seek help, ask him. If you see others in need of help, ask him. But you have to trust in him. Asking without trust, don't ask. You must place your trust, our love, in our Lord Jesus Christ, always. So thank you, Mom. I know you're on the live stream here, so thank you so much. Let's please, if we would, thank you. Finally, I want to thank the faithful of the Diocese of Fairbanks. You've been praying for a bishop for this past year, and up until a few months ago, none of us knew who that person would be. And I thank you for your fervent prayers. I thank you for your prayers in the months following the announcement as well. One thing that the Lord has begun to taught me so clearly, or perhaps reminded me again at another level of understanding, is how the power of prayer and how much we need to pray for one another and how much we can lift one person up by the gathering together of all our prayers. And so I thank you for your faithfulness and your zeal in these past months. I have felt them, and I ask you to please continue to pray for me, as I will continue to pray for you as well. In this past month of September, I had the opportunity to go out, beautiful month of September, the leaves changing, getting out onto the Yukon River, the Kuskokwim, also as well, had a chance to get out to some of the village, just a bit of the tip of the iceberg, again, in a wonderful time of season. And see the faithful, begin to meet the faithful, begin to meet the priests and the ministers and all who out there committed to our Lord, living the life amid many challenges, but also amid great beauty. Two of the words that I was taught in Amonic, the word koyana, which in Yupik means thank you. And I also learned in Nulato, anamase, which is Athabascan for thank you. And so to the communities that I have visited in this past month, Koyana and Anamasai, thank you so much for your warm welcome and for your prayers. And for the communities that I have yet to visit and see, I look very much forward to meeting you, celebrating the Eucharist, receiving the life that Christ gives us in the Holy Eucharist in these upcoming months. Very exciting times. Again, I thank you for your prayers. So much to say. But I think Koyana says it all to our Lord, right? We say that together to our Lord Jesus Christ. Anamase. Anamase. We praise our Lord Jesus Christ, and most of all, we know that in you, all of us gathered here today and joining us on the live stream everywhere, all of us, all the faithful, all the people of the Diocese of Fairbanks and around the world, in all of you, to quote St. Peter, in all of you, God is to be glorified through Jesus Christ. Amen. Thank you, brothers and sisters. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for the blessing.
O God, who care for your people with gentleness and rule them with love, endow with the spirit of wisdom those to whom you have handed on the authority to govern, that from the flourishing of a holy flock may come eternal joy for its shepherds. Amen. Amen. As in your majestic power, you allot the number of our days and the measure of our years, look favorably upon our humble service and confer on our time the abundance of your peace.
Amen.
Give a happy outcome to the tasks that through your grace you have laid upon me, whom you have raised to the rank of bishop. Make me pleasing to you in the fulfillment of my duties, and so guide the hearts of people and pastor, that the obedience of the flock may never fail the shepherd, nor the care of the shepherd be lacking for the flock.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you, who are gathered here, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.